So we're going to get started, everyone. Today, the Jacques Initiative, a program of the Institute of Human Virology at the University of Maryland School of Medicine, in partnership with the Maryland State AIDS Administration and multiple partners in the faith-based community, are here to kick off a project called Project Shalem, with today being a specific focus on encouraging the citizens of Baltimore to be tested for HIV. Today we will, and as a matter of fact, we have begun to test 1,000 people in our city through 11 sites that are across the region.
With the national estimates of 21% with HIV who do not know their status, we estimate that there are another 6,000 to 9,000 persons in Maryland with HIV who do not know their status.
Yes, there are people in this city that are living in fear, and they need to know that we are around them to provide care and comfort and support. And I think that we've been asking many of the wrong questions, and we need to begin to ask new questions.
This concept of every church and every faith-based community, every mosque, every synagogue, becoming a testing place. And we must be reminded that Baltimore is leading the way in making the difference and making a difference and changing people's lives by what is occurring here today and at 11 other sites.
Our success over the next decade is going to be directly correlated to our ability to partner. The ultimate goal is a sustainable project where the church, the mosque, and the synagogue become a safe place to hold a discussion about HIV and to be tested.
See, my mom had just passed last year. She had full-blown AIDS. Okay. My mother used to do drugs, and she had a partner that had HIV, and he didn't tell her that she had HIV. And like 5 years ago, she found out that she had it, and he disappeared. Then she passed it on to my father.
You know, I think this is a good thing you're doing here because I really want to be educated about this HIV and AIDS thing, because I'm pretty much promiscuous in my approach to life out there on the streets.
Now my father have it, but my father taking like very good care of himself, so everything's all right. So now I'm like overprotective about it because I don't want to go through the same thing that my mother had went through.
And I just need to know, you know, do I or don't I? Because I know my brother has AIDS, full-blown AIDS.
We're hoping today to be able to test everyone that comes through the door in any one of those sites.
First of all, we have foot soldiers out on the street that are kind of recruiting and letting people know that we are here, that we're providing the testing, that it is free, that it's quick, it's easy, there are no needles involved, which is a big selling point.
Well, everyone, as they come in, they're first greeted, and then they go through a process of filling out information about their history.
Testing consent forms, things like that.
We have the person come in, they sit down, we swab the cheek, we put the Q-tip inside of a solution. It takes about 20 minutes for the results. While they're waiting for the results,
we give them some snacks and try to educate them.
They come back and get the test results if they're positive or negative.
Those who receive a positive result would then go into counseling immediately.
We have support inside and outside the church if you want to go the religious route, or if you know you want to just go through doctors or whatnot. We have both ways.
And then through Jacques Initiative, they're provided health care.
What it's doing is it's giving back to the community something that is needed. A lot of the people that we see will not go to the hospital, they will not go to a doctor, even with the insurance that they have, they will not visit. So we're bringing to them what they need, not only food today, but the blessing of medical attention.
It's great that Jacques Initiative came out today to the community, because if they weren't here, they would not get tested. Some of these people don't like clinic settings, don't like hospitals, and we're out here in their home testing them, so I think it's great.
The highest infection is caused because we don't know our status.
And among the Hispanic population, we are so afraid to know what's going on.
Yo creo que es importante porque es para el mismo beneficio del pueblo, tanto latino, americano, y yo creo que como dice Dios que somos uno, y entonces ese es el propósito que se está haciendo todo esto, unánimes.
Volunteers are the critical component of this activity today.
I'm not afraid, I can't explain. I'm not so proud, I've made mistakes. I'll never be ashamed of your life.
We can't sit in our comfortable churches, our comfortable jobs, our comfortable homes, and act like people out there are not dying.
There's no way the Jacques Initiative could have done this without the partnerships that we have with the Gallery Church, with Hope Springs, with the other faith-based groups, and really with the State AIDS Administration, who has worked alongside of us to implement this program, which is unique and different from anything that's been done before.
Good results, man. Good results. Stay positive. I mean, stay negative. Don't be positive.
I'm negatory, and I really feel good about that. At least I know.
Sometimes I feel like dying, but your love gets in my way, my way.
All right.
So now I just stop trying, and I live from day to day. How do I give back when I don't?